So the answer is 3. Why is that? Well, here's the code. Let's take it step by step. First of all, every thread is just setting a local variable equal to its own thread index. Then in this line, we're declaring a shared variable, which is going to be shared by all the threads in the thread block. And I just hard coded in 128 elements here. And now we're actually going to do something. We're going to write, every thread is going to write into a single element of the array corresponding to its thread index. And the thing that it's going to write into that element of the array happens to be its own thread index. Okay, so this is going to load up that array with 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And that's just to put something in the array that we can play with. This operation is a write. So we need a barrier after this write completes in order to make sure that nobody tries to read from the array until after all of the threads have finished the write operation. So let's insert a barrier here. And now all of the threads that pass this if statement are going to do this shift operation, right? They're going to set the array element at their index equal to the array element at their index plus 1. But if you think about it, this is really a read and a write operation. Here was our first write operation. That was number 1. And now we're doing a read operation. That's number 2. Okay, we're going to read from the array at index plus 1. And then finally, we're going to write to the array at index. And that's operation 3. And the tricky thing about this is that all of these reads should complete before we allow any of these writes to finish. So really, we need to restructure this code. We'll make this read operation explicit, put it in a local temporary variable. We'll call sync threads. We'll perform the write operation explicitly. And then just to be absolutely safe, before anybody can use these written values, we need another sync threads to ensure that all of these write operations have completed before anybody attempts to do anything with this array value afterwards.